When you take a swim in the local pool, how much of someone else's pee will you be swallowing if you take a mouthful of water? It's an important question. Even Olympian Michael Phelps admits to occasionally spending a penny while swimming, and despite warning notices at most pools against public urination, you can be sure that when you next take a dip, someone will have ignored them. So when you do inadvertently take a gulp of water while swimming, how much of that will be someone else's liquid waste? For a quick back-of-the-envelope calculation, assume we're talking about an Olympic-sized pool here, containing around 2.5 million litres of water. Now let's assume one of your fellow swimmers takes a long and satisfying, but surreptitious, pee, releasing about half a litre of liquid into the pool. And finally, assume that you accidentally gulp up to a tenth of a litre of the resulting cocktail. In that mouthful, you would imbibe a whopping 20 nanolitres of your fellow swimmer's pee. If this was a droplet of pure pee, it would be smaller than a grain of salt. Of course, that's assuming that the pee mixes through the pool evenly, which it probably won't, at least not straight away. Even so, you've not got much to worry about beyond feeling icky, especially as there's not much in pee that's harmful. There is a complication, though. The uric acid in pee reacts with chlorine used to disinfect pools to produce a much more toxic substance. This is cyanogen chloride, and it's nasty stuff. So nasty that all production must be reported to the Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons. On exposure, symptoms can vary from skin and eye irritation to nausea, vomiting, and at high concentrations, death. But you need quite a lot of it to cause an effect. Adults can be exposed to up to 3.5 milligrams of the stuff per day before it's considered a problem. So how does that compare to what might be in your pee-infused mouthful of swimming pool water? In that one mouthful, you'd be drinking less than 2.5 picograms of cyanogen chloride. This is 1,000 million times smaller than the safe level. In fact, the folks over at Ars Technica calculated that you'd need 3 million people in the pool all peeing at the same time, and so much chlorine that it would be burning the skin off your bones before cyanogen chloride became close to being a problem. So despite the yuck factor of swallowing someone else's pee and the fear factor that comes from anything associated with cyanide, because of the low doses, the risks in this case are, if you'll forgive the pun, piddlingly small. For more information on pee, pools and cyanogen chloride, check out the links below. And as always, please do join the conversation in the comments.